Hello everyone, myself Suma BT, working as an assistant professor in mechanical department at SJBET. Today I am going to give a brief introduction about the experiment LVDT. This will come under mechanical measurement and metrology lab. This LVDT means, you should know about the abbreviation, linear variable differential transformer. It works on the principle of mutual inductions. In this we have three coils will be there, secondary coil, two secondary coils and one central primary core will be there, and the two secondary coils will be working on the mutual induction. And they say, you can say this is the core, this we have a linear movement, mechanical force we are going to apply here, and this is the electrical setup. In this the mechanical force will be converted into electrical energy. This we are going to take a readings. See here, you can see this is a micrometer. You should know the least count of this micrometer. The least count of micrometer will be 0.01 mm. And this is the core, and this you can move clockwise direction and even anti-clockwise direction. This you can see the knobs. So according to the color code, you should plug in. For the blue color, you have to plug in the blue. For the black color, red, green and yellow color. According to that, you have to plug in. Initially, we need to switch on the here. There is a power on button. You need to switch on and leave it for 10 minutes for warm up. And then after warming up, you have to, this is a knob you can observe here. This is a zero knob and this is the calibration knob. And this will, you can read the readings here. This is the zero knob, this is the calibration knob, and this we can see the readings. And this is the micrometer, and this will be the core movement. See here, you can read this is a pitch scale reading, and this will be the main scale reading. See, if you rotate this pitch scale reading in a two turns, it will move 1 mm. One rotation will be 0.5 mm and two rotation will be 1 mm. See here, this is a main scale reading and this will be the pitch scale reading. Initially what we have to do, we have to coincide with the pitch scale zero reading to main scale reading initially, and then this the 10, this is a 5 mm, this will be the 10 mm, this will take it as a null position. So if we move null position, this will coincide with a zero, and then we have to set it for zero. So it is not in a zero now. You can see here 0.48 mm. See, first you have to put it zero here. You have to set by using a zero knob, zero. So this is very sensitive machine. You have to do it very carefully. A 1.5-2 mm difference will be there. Don't leave. See, you can observe here zero it has come, and here also the zero point will be coincided with the null position. So now what we have to do, you rotate the micrometer in a clockwise direction. If you rotate the clockwise direction, you are getting a positive reading here. So similarly, if you rotate the knob in the anti-clockwise direction, it is coming right side. So you can observe, it has come negative reading. So that means this is a null position. If you take the clockwise direction, if you rotate, the core will move leftward, that is a positive reading. From the null position, if you rotate in anti-clockwise direction, it moves towards the right, we can take a negative reading. You can observe. First, what you have to do, just you have to move it until you will get a 10 mm. So first we need to calibrate the setup. 10 mm means rotations, you have to move it, and this zero pitch scale zero reading should coincide exactly. See, you can observe. See, for the 10 mm, you can observe 9. It is almost nearer to 10 mm, 9.30. Now you have to calibrate it for 10 mm by using a calibration knob. For setting up the 0, you have to use a 0 knob. For setting up a calibration, you have to use calibration knob. You set it for 10 mm. So you should not leave pressure on the this board. This is fine. 1 or 2 mm difference will be there. So this is the positive value, note down the reading. And then, now the setup is calibrated. Now if you want to take a reading, again you go to null position. Which one is the null position here? 10 mm. 10 mm is a null position. Just rotate it, it should show the zero. Then what you have to do is, if you take, keep on rotating, if you rotate the two rotations, you will get a 1 mm and then take down the reading. This will be the initial reading, and whatever the readings, you will get it in this setup. And then the difference between the reading from here and the reading from here, it will be the error. Then you have to plot a graph of null position you have to plot a graph, and then you have to, from the core position leftward, you have to take a negative readings, and from the right you have to take a positive. Like that, depending upon the rotation, you have to take a clockwise and anti-clockwise rotation. Now the experiment is completed. Take 10 or 15 readings and try to plot a graph. And what are the Viva questions they'll ask is, what is meant by LVDT? Abbreviation you should know, and what principle it is going to work. It is works on the principle of mutual induction. What are the advantages? So the main advantages is, we can measure, this can be measured, use it to measure the force, and from the fraction to even the centimeter displacement you can measure from this LVDT. And main advantages is, this is very sensitive and we are getting the accurate value from this LVDT. And you should know what is the primary coil and what are the secondary coils, how you will get a net output and all, you should know about this experiment. Thank you.